Hey, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, welcome to another video with me, John. Today I'm going to be doing an in the bowl of ramen. It's been a little bit since I've done a bowl of ramen, and I've had this sitting in my cupboard for a while, waiting to try it. I got distracted by a few other things, but I'm back doing another ramen review for you. Now, this ramen that I have here is kind of special. I have done ramen in a top 10 and a bottom 10 list from the one and only Hans the Ramen Raider. Now, last time I did one from his bottom 10, it was pretty bad, and I threw it away. And the last time I did one of them on his top 10, I liked it a lot, and I ate it all, and it's gone. This one is on his top 10, but not only is it on his top 10, it is the number one best ramen he's ever reviewed of all time, and I think he's almost up to 1,000 different ramens that he's reviewed. So let me tell you what it is. This is Laksa Whole Grain Ramen from Prima Foods, Singapore. So it is a Singapore, made in Singapore, is a steamed non-fried noodle. So the noodles are not fried, they're steamed and then dried. So it, usually that means it takes a little bit longer to cook and the quality of the noodles a little bit better. This laksa flavor, laksa is some type of herb, I think, and it has like a coconut milk powder to it. The paste has chili paste, shrimp, shallots, shrimp paste, turmeric, lemongrass, and laksa leaf. And then there's a powdery mix that you get that's coconut milk powder, sugar, salt, yeast. So those are the two things. When you make this, it comes with of course, noodles, but then you get two packs on the inside. One is a laksa paste, and the other is a coconut milk powder. And you make it like you make any typical ramen. You know, boil the noodles, mix the powder and the sauce together. But this one, if you can look, I don't know if you can see it very well here, but it's very like milky, thick looking. The broth is not clear at all. It's very milky. And the noodles are thick. And without any further ado, let's just get on with it and taste it and see if I agree that this is the best ramen that you can get. Cheers. Interesting. I'm gonna take a little sip of the broth here. Now the flavor's not like overwhelmingly strong, but it is kind of, it's rich. And it's basically, to me, I can pick out two flavors. There's definitely like coconut flavor, there's definitely like a seafood flavor, and it says like shrimp or prawn in here. And these noodles, they're whole grain, but they don't taste like a very weedy or like you would think like a whole wheat bread would taste. But it is like thicker and chewier almost. Almost like it has a slight grit to it, but I wouldn't consider it gritty. If you didn't know these are whole wheat noodles, you probably wouldn't be able to tell. The flavor of this is pretty top notch. I'm not gonna lie. I'm enjoying it. I'm definitely gonna finish it, and definitely looking forward to eating the rest that came in the pack. Though I wouldn't consider this my favorite instant ramen that I've ever had. But it is definitely up there. I do agree, it's top 10 worthy. And I definitely try it again. And I definitely try more of the products that Prima Taste offers. But this one's definitely good. If you really like creamy, rich broths, this one's for you. To me, the only thing that makes this one not my favorite is that I kind of enjoy more pork-based broths. And this is a, protein-wise, this is a seafood-based broth. And I don't dislike seafood, I just like pork-based broth better. But this is good. I'm gonna give this ramen a 9 out of 10. Thank you to the Ramen Raider for putting this on my radar by just reviewing it and giving it such high praise. I really enjoyed it. That's it. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. This ramen, I actually bought it straight from the Prima Taste website. I think I also saw it at some stores. Maybe not the whole wheat variety. This does come in regular and whole wheat. Or whole grain, sorry. The regular variety I found at different Asian grocery stores. But he specifically put the whole grain variety on the number one. So I really wanted to see his number one, what it tastes like, how I felt about it. And that's why I went online and purchased a whole grain variety. But I think the flavor packet is the same regardless if it's whole grain or not. And to me, the main part of this that makes it taste as good as it does is that flavor packet. So you should be able to go to your local grocery store, your Asian grocery store, to find the Laksa original, not the whole grain. And in the future, I'll probably go that route to, if I'm going to purchase this again. But anyway, thanks for watching it. Give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. If you haven't heard, my brother, Derek, who used to be in videos with me, he's still going to be in some videos with me in the future, but he has created his own YouTube channel, and I'm just going to give a shout out to that. And his YouTube channel is called The Fat Hipster's Brother, very original name, and currently he's doing some reviews on a series of different things. He's doing like veggie burgers, which I think are disgusting, but if that's for you, go ahead and try that out. And then he's doing different types of jerky meats, some exotic meats there, and some interesting flavors. And then he's also doing some like yeast extracts like Vegemite and Promite and all the other mites. But go ahead, I'm gonna hopefully put a link to his channel in the description. Maybe put like a thing right here where you can subscribe to his channel. And if you like that, tell him that the Fat Hipster sent you to his channel, and give him a subscribe as well. He's just starting out, so he doesn't have too many subscribers, so he really needs you guys' support as well. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye.